Now I move on, verse 8 of chapter 5 of Job. I would seek unto God, and unto God would I commit my cause, which doeth great things and unsearchable, marvelous things without number, who giveth rain upon the earth, and sendeth waters upon the fields, to set up on high those that be low, that those which mourn may be exalted to safety. He disappointeth the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the froward is carried headlong. They meet with darkness in the daytime, and grope in the noontime as in the night. But he saveth the poor from the sword, from their mouth, and from the hand of the mighty, so the poor hath hope, and iniquity stoppeth her mouth. Now, what he's saying here, and he's saying it really in a beautiful way, is that God is faithful, and God is good, and God is just. That's the thing that he's saying. Well, that's true, but that doesn't reach the root of the problem of this man Job. He's not talking to Job, actually. Now, verse 17, he says, "Behold, happy is the man whom God correcteth. Therefore despise not thou the chastening of the Almighty." And I've heard that verse quoted again and again. Now somebody says, but isn't it true? Yes, but this was given as a personal dig against Job. And that doesn't always explain the reason that God's people suffer. We've gone over a list here, and there are several reasons. And sometimes you can use this as a little dagger to put in the heart of some friend and say, what's happening is you're wrong. God's correcting you. Well, that could be, but it may not be. And who are you? Have you just telephoned into heaven and the Lord's let you in on something? Some people speak ex cathedra and they're not even the Pope. They think that they have the last word. Well, my friend, you can't speak always into the problem of someone else. And then someone else can't always speak into your problem either. Now, verse 18, "For he maketh sore and bindeth up, he woundeth, and his hands make whole." What a wonderful picture of God, and it is a picture of him. "He shall deliver thee in 6 troubles, yea, in 7, there shall no evil touch thee." And he mentions, you see, 6, and then you'll notice that occurs in the book of Proverbs. And it's not just a poetic expression. It means 7 is actually not necessarily the number of perfection. It's always the number of completeness. The 7th day was the end of 1 week. 1 week had come to an end. And actually, 7 is the number of completeness. And so this is the total spectrum of the trouble of man.